Hello and welcome to Green Scene, EPA's series of environmental podcasts that you can take with you. I'm Judy Pino. Acid rain is one of the most requested topics here at EPA from school systems and teachers. And today, we are coming to you from the Koshland Science Museum in Washington, D.C., one of the nation's premier environmental education interactive exhibition spaces, to introduce to you the Acid Rain Teacher's Guide as part of the EPA's public outreach on acid rain. And to tell us more about this very important project is Brian McLean, EPA's Office of Atmospheric Programs, and students who are here today joining us from KIPP KEY Academy in Southeast Washington, grades 6 through 8. Welcome, everybody. Hi, Brian. Well, you've been with the EPA for 20 years and have been instrumental in developing EPA's programs to reduce acid rain. Can you tell us what is acid rain and what EPA is doing about it?
Okay. Well, acid rain is a fascinating problem because it's so complicated that people didn't understand it at first. It actually forms in the atmosphere from pollutants that come from power plants mostly. And when it mixes with moisture and other chemicals in the air, it transforms into acidic compounds, wet or dry compounds, that then later fall to the earth, sometimes several hundred miles away. So when we first discovered these problems, they were in the lakes in the Adirondacks in New York, and there were no pollution sources around these lakes. People couldn't understand why the lakes were becoming acidic and the fish were dying. And it took a long time for people to understand that this pollution was actually moving hundreds of miles from where the power plants were to where the lakes were, and falling on the trees and falling on the ground and into the lakes. And so it took quite a bit of scientific investigation before people connected the cause with the transformation, with the deposition of the chemicals onto the ground.
So you, of all people, in 20 years have been able to see a difference.
Yes. In fact, it took almost 20 years for people to really understand this problem before we began to solve it. And that started, the solutions we imposed were in the 1990s. We passed a Clean Air Act, and then in 1995, we began to reduce emissions from power plants all across the United States. And since 1995, we've reduced them now by over 40%. And we have noticed changes in the deposition has changed, it's less acidic, the lakes are becoming less acidic. And so this turned out to be a scientific investigation that led to really almost a grand experiment in real time by reducing the emissions and then measuring the effect of those reductions on the planet.
As we mentioned, acid rain is one of the topmost topics that people are requesting, and for that reason EPA has created a teacher's guide. Tell us a little bit about that.
Well, actually, even before we started solving the problem, as we began to understand it and people were so interested in it, we developed a teacher's guide back in the early 1990s. And because we were getting so many requests, people wanted to understand what is causing this and then what can we do about it. And so back then, we simply were describing what we understood about the problem, and we decided to put in some experiments so that students in schools could actually test and understand what was happening. And then in the last several years, we've added not only the information about it, but then we started adding information about what we're doing about it and how we're reducing emissions to deal with the problem.
And this is not the first time that EPA has created a teacher's guide on acid rain.
That's correct. And what we're sort of announcing right now is that we have updated this. We have new experiments in there for people to use. We've tested those, and we've added a lot of new information.
And of course, we can't visit one of the most premier environmental education interactive exhibition spaces without doing a little bit of science. And Flora Lehrman is a teacher at KIPP KEY Academy. Thanks for being with us, Flora.
Hi.
Hi. And you have some of your students here. They are doing some science experiments in the guidebook, from the guidebook.
Yes, we're actually doing experiment number 2 from the guidebook. And right now, these science scholars are looking at different levels of acidity. They're measuring the pH levels of fruits, juices, and other household items. As you can see, the science scholars have started already, and they're now just in the process of measuring and recording their results.
Okay, guys, go ahead. In the meantime, we'll continue talking. Brian, how important is it that that the experiments be easy for the teachers and the students so they really understand what acid rain is all about and how to prevent it.
The basic concepts and the experiments they're doing are very similar to what we do in the real world. We use more sophisticated instruments, and we have monitors all around the country checking on what's going on. But what they're looking at is how you can measure the acidity of various common things that we have in the house, from fruits and vegetables to other liquids. We do the same thing. We're measuring air, we're measuring the soil, we're measuring the water in lakes, and we're doing the same kind of thing, except with much more expensive instruments,
sure.
And much more widespread. But it's the same kind of method that we use. And by understanding it, they can appreciate what actually goes into evaluating and understanding a problem and solving a problem.
Now let's talk to some of these science scholars. I'm interested in knowing what do you think about acid rain, and how important is it that you prevent acid rain?
Well, it's very important that you prevent it because it destroys our community and our trees, and so it could affect us in some way. Or how, if you if you love nature, then this is a big problem for you and even for people who don't really love nature. So, and it really destroys our community and our homes.
What about the science experiments? Do you think these are important so you guys could understand a little bit more about acid rain? Yes? And what are you doing to prevent acid rain?
Well, to prevent acid rain, I'm trying not to use as much as electricity as I used to.
That's great advice, and we could all learn from that, right, Brian?
Yes.
And Brian, I understand that one of the most popular aspects of this guide is the 9 science experiments, such as the one that the kids are doing today. Tell us about these experiments and the reason for including them in the guide.
Well, we found that when people want to understand a problem, the best thing to do is to actually go through the process of testing and experimenting just the way we would do, and people really understand that there are liquids and chemicals and we can measure them and test them. And so we have developed and in the last few years revised these experiments to make them very to the point, explicit, so that people can understand, students can understand exactly what we do when we're measuring.
Okay, guys, so the kids have been working on their experiments. What are the results, teacher?
Well, as you can see, the soap is a base, and the fruit and the juices and the soda are acids, and water is close to neutral.
Is that a good thing?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we want to keep our water neutral so that it's not acidic, so that when it comes down, it's not acid rain.
Great. Well, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
And thank you, Brian McLean of EPA's Office of Atmospheric Programs, Ms. Flora Lehrman, teacher at KIPP KEY Academy in Southeast, and all of our students in the studio today, and of course, Koshland Science Museum in downtown Washington, D.C., one of the nation's premier environmental education interactive spaces, for helping us out with this very important green scene. And for more information on what EPA is doing to reduce acid rain, please visit www.epa.gov/acid rain. To find out more about the Koshland Science Museum, go to the address on screen. The guide, Learning About Acid Rain, a teacher's guide for grades 6 through 8, we should say, is also available online for download at www.epa.gov/acid rain. And of course, printed copies are available for free through the Acid Rain Hotline on the screen now. Thank you very much for being with us. Thanks, Brian.
Thank you.